fired, Phil. Johnson, you're fired. Carey, Johnson was going to do inventory this weekend. Now it's up to you.
Inventory on the weekend? Thank you, sir. Woo!
Happy over inventory. Carey, your life is worse than I'd hoped.
I'm just happy I won't have to volunteer at that stinking nursing home again. If I want to get yelled at and treated like I'm nothing, I'll come straight to you, sir.
Thank you, Carey. Volunteer at a nursing home, eh? That's just the kind of original and unique idea I could take credit for.
Good morning, people.
Mrs. Lauder, have you ever thought about nursing homes?
What? You're fired.
No, not you. I think of you as my baby sister. No, I mean, what would you think of our employees volunteering at local nursing homes? At the weekends, of course.
I love it. Let's run with it. Carey, as head of human resources, I'm putting you in charge of organizing the spontaneous outpouring of kindness.
Back to the boneyard.
Excuse me. I think we found Carey's number two. Back to work, everybody.
Seesaw. Well, that was an awkward situation. Here's another. The volunteer program is mandatory.
So you're forcing people to volunteer. Gee, that's kind of ironic.
Oh, look, everybody. Carey's detected an irony. He's smart. Smarter than me. And yet, I still make more money. Oh, look. Now I've detected an irony. Everyone, I'm ready to judge this floor's entry in the Beautify Your Workstation contest. So if you want those two tickets to the Bahamas, pucker up, one butt, no waiting.
So that's not garbage, that's for our Christmas toy drive.
Yes, I'm well aware. It is a toy. Kenny Cuppy. Merry Christmas, everyone! All right, Mimi, what grotesque vision of hell have you brought us this year?
Well, it ain't much, but I hope you like it.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Send Mimi to the Bahamas! She really works hard! She has to look at Drew. He's a big pig. He's a dinosaur in a swimsuit. He shouldn't get the prize!
Wait a second, it's not fair to use cute little kids.
Bite a snow boy, bite a snow boy, bite a snow boy. You dork.
Well, Mimi, that's incredible. You've actually managed to recreate the Abbey of my childhood.
Well, I did a little research.
Yes, apparently not enough. I was beaten up by every choir boy and nun in the whole stinking place. You lose.
We wish you hadn't said that. We wish you hadn't said that. We wish you hadn't said that. We know where you live.
All right, Kenny, let's see what you've got.
Well, it's not adorable little children desecrating religious music, sir, but it's the best I could do. I can eat everything in my cubicle.
What's new about that?
Do I dare dream it?
Yes, sir. Peppermint pink slips. They're made out of rice paper. Go ahead and try one.
Oh. Melty. Minty.
Well, sir, I'm the last cubicle. Time to judge the winner.
Well, I'm very impressed with your efforts, Carey, but on the other hand, O'Brien's over there all tarted up. Oh, what the heck? It's a tie. One ticket for you, one ticket to you.
Hey, I wanted to take my boyfriend.
And I wanted to take Nikki.
I want to give a damn. No, I do. I really, really do. But I don't.
Jessica, I've got to have it right now.
Kenny! Well, well, well. Who's this giving you orders?
This is my other boss.
So you're the other boss. Younger, too. What a surprise. You've got some nerve coming in here.
Look, I guess this was going to come up sooner or later. But we're both adults. This is the 90s. There's no reason we can't share it.
Is this what you want, Kenny?
I don't know anymore.
All right, let's be civilized. I'll take the days, you take the nights. I'll throw in the weekends if you give me every other lunch hour.
Fine, if I can have his vacation.
Deal.
Wait a second. You're dividing up my entire life. What if I wanna... What if I get invited to... What if I get tickets for... Hey! How can be people never invite me anywhere or give me tickets to anything? Oh, what are you complaining about, Carrie? I'm giving you a successful beer business.
Yes, and I'm giving you blah, blah, promises, promotion, blah, blah, blah. This has all worked out terribly well, Clemens. You're a heck of a boss, you know. In fact, go on, give it a go.
No, I couldn't.
Please, I insist.
Johnson, get a load of this. What's black and white and can fire you?
Us!
You're fired!
Morning, Mimi. You look sexy today.
I look sexy every day. What the hell's going on?
I need to talk to you. No, no, not my office. It could be bugged. We need to find somewhere private, a dead zone, somewhere management doesn't even know exists.
Drew's cubicle?
Perfect. Now, Mimi, I want to sexually harass you.
Ready? You need a minute? Dude,
not now, not here, not really.
Then why the yank?
It's part of my plan to get back at Winfred Lauder. They're going to fire me.
But you're beautiful. Unless, of course, they're firing all the beautiful people. Holy cripes, I'm next!
No, 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 it's just me. Here, look at this confidential memo I accidentally found while rifling through Mrs. Lauder's purse.
Agenda for Friday, reschedule board meeting. Oh my God! Celebrate Mr. Wick's firing next Friday!
Celebrating! They're celebrating the fortune they're saving, firing me a month before I'm vested for pension. I'll lose everything and be deported.
So what you're telling me is that you want to do it with me before you go back to that sexless country?
There's a little more to it. I sexually harass you. You sue the company. I confess. And you win millions. Then we split the money and live a life of luxury in some remote tropical island.
What do you say?
Slow the boat, mister. I ain't gonna lie about sexual harassment.
Damn.
You're gonna actually have to do it.
Damn. I mean great.
And after we do it, and we rehearse a little, well, we're gonna need a witness. Someone gullible.
Yes, a real stooge. Someone easily manipulated. Now, who do I have in the palm of my hand? I know Henderson and shoes.
Henderson? She's practically 300 years old, can't hardly remember to put her pants on.
All this energy.
Or Coulter.
Oh, no, not since the stroke. Called Mick Churchill in the elevator this morning.
What about me?
Such a crude attitude.
O'Connor?
It's backward. No.
Leader?
No.
Nagel?
No.
Madeline?
No.
Firestein?
No.
Graham?
No.
Mulroy?
No.
What about Cooter in accounting?
No.